Very good morning, students. This is Jay Vishakhan. For today's session, I'm going to solve a couple of problems from rectilinear motion. Let me read out this question to extract the inputs, that is given data. A train starts from rest, attains a velocity of 45 km/h in 2 minutes with uniform acceleration. Calculate acceleration, distance travel in this time 2 minutes, time required to reach a velocity of 36 km/h. Right, given data. A train starts from rest. That means initial velocity equal to zero. When any object or vehicle starts from rest, means there is no initial velocity, and attains a velocity of 45 km, which is final velocity, 45 km/h. The unit of velocity should be always in meter per second, so this can be converted with 1 km is 1000 meters, so multiply with 1000. 1 hour is 3600 seconds, right? So that is 60 into 60, which works out. Twelve point five meter per second. So what I did was I converted the kilometer per hour into meter per second. To convert kilometer to meter, multiplied with 1000. For hour, that is in the denominator, so 1 hour is 3600 seconds, right? So I divided with this value, got the final velocity in meter per second in 2 minutes. That is, time taken is 2 minutes. The unit should be always in seconds. So 1 minute is 60 seconds. So this needs to be converted into seconds, right? Calculate one, that is to find acceleration, distance travel in this time 2 meter. That is, yes, when t is equal to 2 minutes, that is 120 seconds. Third, time required to reach a velocity of 36 km/h. So t, when velocity equal to 36 km/h, I'm going to convert the velocity kilometer per hour into meter per second. So 36 into 1000 divided by 3600. Solution. I taught you three formulas, right? First one is V is equal to U plus AT. S is equal to UT plus of AT square. Then V square is equal to U square minus 2AS. To find the acceleration, check what are the inputs are here. So velocity is there, that is final velocity, initial velocity, time is there. So I can use the first formula to find the acceleration. So U is equal to U plus AT, V is 12.5, U is 0, plus A into 120 seconds. Therefore, A equal to 12.5 divided by 120. Point 104 meter square per second. So got a value for acceleration. Now second, distance traveled in this time 2 meters. That is, S need to find when the time is 2 meter per second. So this formula should be used here. S is equal to ut plus of at square. U is 0. Time is 120 seconds plus 1 by 2 into acceleration is 0.104. Time is 120 seconds square. That is equal to 0 plus 120 square into 0.104 into 0.5, which works out 748.8 meter. Therefore, S is equal to 748.8 meter. Let's move to the third question, the sub question, where it says time required to reach the velocity of 36 kilometer. In the velocity was 45 kilometer. When the speed is reduced to 36 kilometer per hour, then how much time it is required? So the known formula is V is equal to U plus AT. V is known, which is 10 meter per second. 10 equal to U is equal to 0. Acceleration is 0.104 into T. Therefore, T equal to 10 divided by 0.104. 10 divided by 0.104, which works out 96.15 seconds. So pick up the suitable formula for each and every question. So these are the three. When the motion is horizontal, that is the object or body or a particle moving on the horizontal direction or horizontal motion, then these are the three formula to be used. So next question, what it says, let me read out this. A steel ball is thrown vertically upwards from the top of the building 25 meter above the ground with an initial velocity of 18 meter per second. Find the maximum height reached by the ball from the ground. So given data, a steel ball is thrown vertically upwards from the top of the building 25 meter above, that is building height. That the height of the building is, height of the building is 25 meter with an initial velocity of 18 meter per second. U is equal to 18 meter per second. Find the maximum reached by the ball from the ground, that is maximum height to find. Maximum height is equal to what? Solution. I taught you three categories under the rectilinear motion. When the body is moving in the horizontal direction, set of formula to be used. When the particle or object is moving vertically downwards, set of formulas. Then when the particle moves in the vertical upwards, the set of formulas. Look at here. Here the object is moving vertically upward. So set of formulas are V is equal to U minus GT, right? V is equal to U plus AT for horizontal. So just replace A with G, and since the object is going against gravity, so it carries negative symbol. H is equal to UT plus, that is minus of GT square. V square is equal to U square minus 2G H. These are the three formulas. When the particle moving vertically upwards, that is against gravity. look at the question, what are the inputs are given. Building height is given and U is given, right? Find the maximum height reached by the ball, right? So formula I am going to use is V square minus 2gh. When the ball reaches the maximum height, what would be the final velocity? When it attains the maximum height, the final velocity will be zero, isn't it? Right. When the ball reaches maximum height, final velocity shall be zero. Right. So now we apply. Zero is equal to U square. That is 18 square minus 2. G is nothing but the constant acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.81 into height. So you should not substitute the height value here. This is the building height, but the ball has been thrown from the top of the building, right? From the top of the building, the ball is thrown. The height of the building is 25. So don't get confused here. Therefore, h is equal to 18 square divided by 2 into 9.81. 16.51 meter. Clear? So this is the height of the ball which is thrown from the top of the building. Then total height would be how much from the ground? Yes. The total height from ground equal to height of the building, which is 25, plus the ball reached from the top of the building to the space, which is 16.51. So which works out 41.5 meter. So H max is equal to 41.5 meter. Thank you for watching. Bye.